How's it going, YouTube? This is Mitch Santona bringing you a review of the 2010s. Well, it's Revenge of the Fallen slash Hunt for the Decepticons slash Generations 2010 slash I don't even know what line anymore. Elita 1. So she is a very nice looking bike. I enjoy this bike. Actually, I think that may be up like that. Yeah. Decent bike mode. This is cool. I don't mind it. I like it. Okay. Let's go. Character on Elita 1. I'd give her a 5. Why? Because just what her bio states. I mean, it doesn't refer to the Elita 1 of Generation 1 that I know of. I mean, it didn't seem like it to me. And she was just, I guess, I don't know, I mean, really no screen time for the sisters too much. A couple of them got wasted, little chasing at the beginning, and that was really it. So, never really fleshed out. I'm interested to see more, but, and they had some in the comics. I think RC and Chromia, I think, were in the comics. I think she may have been, too, in some of the movie tie-in comics, but I don't know. So, that's all. Mold, 8. Give it an 8. It's got a lot of nice molded in detail. There's a chain, treads on the tires, motorcycle engine parts, a lot of nice little sculpt here on the tailpipes and such. Very sleek design. It's a very nicely molded figure, and it's got a lot of detail in robot mode as well, although I don't like the robot mode. It's just it is detailed, so I will give it that. I'm trying to be objective here. Paint on this guy, this gal, I should say, give her a 4, because you know what, I'm kind of disappointed. I thought the last bike was supposed to be purple. Now, I could be wrong, but I thought I saw the Takara version and it is purple. This is more like a wine color, if you will. And there really is not a lot of paint on it. There's this wine color here, here, and here. And that's it. The rest is all black and silver and gray. So, kind of disappointed in that, to be honest. I wanted a little bit more. Like, if we take her sis, Chromia, the rims are blue. The back here is painted blue. This is all blue up in front. The fender here is blue. And maybe just because this is more of a striking color, more of a contrast to this wine color that kind of blends a little bit too much with the black. I don't know. But I think I prefer Chromia's color scheme better to this. Now, one thing to note here, she also does come with this thing. And you can put it on here and make it like a gun weapon, if you will. And it doesn't really want to stay too well. It's okay. It pops off very easily, but That's like attack mode or something. But we'll get to why we need this in a second when I go to transformation. Oh, I'm sorry. Alt mode here. I skipped the thing. Alt mode, I give a 9 to because I like this bike. Okay, now it's not coming off. Hold on. This is for real, too. Ugh. Sorry. I'm sorry, it goes on way too tight. That was what it was. It falls off way too loose when we go into robot mode. I'll get to that in a second. Alt mode, I give a 9 to. I like this bike. It really is a great bike. And if you're looking for bike transformers and you're going to keep them in bike mode, I do recommend these three gals. Let's get them lined up here. Give you a little bike alt mode shot of the epic Revenge of the Fallen RC sister girls near this thing here. So that's all three, and they do look nice. I really do like them in this mode, and if you keep them in this mode, I think they're pretty swell. So we'll keep these out of here. But back to her transformation, I give a 4-2, and I'm gonna do it off camera and probably be a lot more cursing and throwing things around again. So be back in a flash. Okay, so here's Chromia in her robot mode. I don't have a lot to say. I know this, I usually can't shut up, but I don't know what to do with this. I tried to be very open-minded about this situation, and it ain't doing it for me. Really at all. So, if I have something mistransformed, honestly, I don't care. So she's got a huge arm here, a giant arm that doesn't. Okay, the ball joints don't want to. Wait, there's some mech alive there too, which I can't really figure out what the point of that is, 'cause it's doing nothing for me. Okay, when you move her arm, she just splits in half. So these things don't peg and hold. That's not very good. The head is like kind of jammed down because of other kibble and junk. I may have that wrong, but you know what? Again, don't care. Yeah, there's like a panel here on this arm that interferes with her hand. You can kind of turn it out of the way, but it wants to really fight you. You can go this way with it. It's kind of on some spring, but then if you get it past her elbow, you can't unstraighten her arm. So, yeah. Oh yeah, and by the way, that opens up constantly. This little thing you can configure a number of different ways, whatever way you think looks best. To me, every way looks like crap, so I don't really care. This doesn't do it for me. You know how I say I like quirky? This isn't quirky. This is just kind of. I'm sorry, that's crap. That's not good. I mean, the animated line came out first, and they came out with Prowl. Prowl was a brilliant motorcycle toy. And then this. What is this? I mean, she can shoot this thing somehow, whatever. Where's the stupid launching? I don't even care. It shoots. Whatever. And this thing doesn't. You need this to stand, obviously. If you don't have this, she's absolutely useless. It's a unicycle. Oh, and her chest splits even by moving, just by moving it a little. So you can sense my frustration here with this. This is a crappy toy. I hate it. This is not one of my favorite toys at all. It's one of my least favorite toys in my collection. Her and Chromia actually are better than RC, if you can imagine that. This one's even worse. Now, robot mode on this, I give a 3 to because I'll give it points for being unique, and that's it. Those 3 points are for being unique. And she does have a nice head. Her head is nice, although it can only point down due to the extraneous amount of junk everywhere. Articulation on this gal, I give a 4 to because nothing moves in the fashion that you want it to. Nothing can move in a pose that looks relatively good. I can't straighten this arm out because the joints don't allow it. They kind of bend the wrong way. That's the natural position for that to bend. Whereas I want that the complete opposite, and it doesn't do it without. Ow, I'm breaking something here. This needs to be spun this way, and there's no swivel on it. If I try to turn it out, I rip her head apart. So that's stupid. Real stupid. This arm is a little bit. I don't. Whatever. I'm not even playing with this anymore. This is ridiculous. Yeah, the articulation, I give a 4 to. Quality control, I give a 2 to because nothing stays together. Rating on this girl, I give a 4 to. I say if you like motorcycle transformers to stay transformed in their motorcycle mode, then definitely the girls are cool looking as well, motorcycles. As robots, you like this kind of thing? Knock yourself out. But this is not for me. I don't recommend this toy at all. But I am going to try to combine them because I bought this to combine them, hoping that this would save these girls from, oh, my hatred of them. So I'm going to go watch a review on how to do it because it's 100% not obvious, and she didn't come with the instructions. Okay, so I'm back and I got all three of the sisters combined, and let me tell you, this is most unimpressive. I am highly disappointed with Hasbro in this. Now there's people that are gonna say, "Oh, this is really great. This is oh so cool. Oh, look at how nice it looks." You know what? This is garbage. This is pure garbage. I don't know why I wasted my money buying these three. I mean, just totally waste of money. They combine, and that's what they that this is their combination. I buy her, and I'm like, I'm not buying Chromia because she sucked. I buy Chromia, I'm like, well, Chromia was a little better, but not much. Then I get Alita One, it's just a repaint of Chromia. So I'm like, fine, I'm getting all three of them because now at this point I'm gonna combine them all. And this is the frickin' junk that is given to me. This is the crap you give me. What is this? This doesn't look like anything. It doesn't look like a combined mode. It doesn't look good. It doesn't look anything. It looks like a big pile of frickin' parts. And it's stupid. This, I don't even need that one on there. Here, let me see if I can take it off without the whole thing collapsing. There. There you go. There's a better combined mode. Now I don't have all the crap on the back. Here, this doesn't peg in and stay for anything. It's your stupid arm. I'm gonna gorilla glue that thing in about 2 seconds. Here, what? Really, what is the point of all this crap if it can't move out of the way? This is screwed in. Why? Why is that screwed in? Is it? Here's. There's combined mode. Isn't that impressive? Sorry, so that's been it for this review. I am highly, highly, highly disappointed in these toys. I got suckered into buying Alita One, figuring there was going to be some kind of a cool way to combine the three of them. Or at the very least, Alita One would come with some instructions, and neither one happened. So this is the gem that is the bike combiner, as far as I can get it. So, do I recommend this? Two thumbs down from Mitch Santona.